this week's lesson, which is Under the Sea. We're going to make artwork about things that are under the sea. And it's going to be fun. And you get to choose whatever you want to do. And there are stories and there are music videos and there is fun. So have a good time making your art and enjoy it and show Miss Nelson your pictures, please. Okie dokie.
Out there. This week we're going to be studying oceans and ocean creatures and things that you might find in and around the ocean. But I don't feel too dressed for the ocean right now. Let's see if I can make it better. I said ocean, not beach. Not that I wouldn't want to be going to the beach right now, but I think I'd rather find something a little closer to in the ocean. Okay, this is getting ridiculous. I know squids can be found in the ocean, but I'm thinking of more of like a human-based thing. Mermaids wouldn't work because I wouldn't be able to walk around. Poseidon? No, he can get pretty angry and cause some storms. I know, pirates. I need to become a pirate. Alright! I now totally look like a pirate! But I don't sound like a pirate. I need some help. Arrgh! They sound like pirates. They look like pirates. But I still don't sound like a pirate. I'm gonna get Captain Split Pants Bing to help me become a pirate. Will you do that?
Arr, I will, m'lady.
All right, let's go.
All right, so now me and my mates, give me an R.
Arr!
We're going to teach you the pirate rules. And here we go, pirate rules. Rule number one is no showers. You gotta be stinky. Stinky. Are you stinky enough? I don't know. Stinky. Yeah, I'm pretty stinky. All right. And next, you gotta sing off key. All right. Join with me. Yo ho, blow the man. Come on. You're not singing.
Yo ho,
blow the man down. All right. Very good. Very good. That's really off key. All right. And now, you gotta give a nasty, nasty grin. Nasty grin. Everyone, on the count of three, a nasty grin. One, two, three. Give it to me again. That's not nasty. Nastier. All right. All right. And next, well, we're pirates, but we want to be kind to our families, okay? Be kind to them. A group hug. All right, you're my family. All right. And finally, back to more traditional pirate sort of stuff. The hard stare. So I want you to look over here and give a hard stare. All right. So now let's go and be pirates. Arr.
Being a good pirate is coming up with a good pirate's name, and I want to hear all about your good pirate names, like Allie the Stinky Cat, or Hannah the Rotten Banana, or Missy the Red. That is what I go by, Missy the Red. So think about your pirate name. Maybe look around at objects around you and pick up one of them, and decide to be that, like Fork Pork Chop.
Right, now we're going to learn some pirate expressions. Come on, let me teach you some pirate expressions.
Oh, I'm excited for pirate expressions.
All right.
Okay.
So, the first one is blimey.
Blimey?
Blimey.
Oh, Blimey! Blimey?
Yes.
Oh, Blimey.
Yes. Next is Shiver Me Timbers.
Ah, Shiver Me Timbers.
Yes. And then Grog.
Grog. What is Grog?
It's something we drink.
We drink Grog.
Right. And next we have Land-ho!
Land-ho!
All right.
But I have something you haven't thought about.
What is that?
Pirate booty!
Pirate booty?
Do you know what pirate booty is?
No, tell me, what is pirate booty?
Pirate booty is like when a pirate goes and steals stuff, the booty is the treasure. Mm. But because I don't want my students stealing anything, we're going to make pirate booty a food recipe. I mean, pirate booty is going to be a food recipe.
Get in my belly.
Right in the belly. So would you care to join us while we make our own pirate booty?
Why, certainly.
Let's go.
Let's go.
So, Pirate Bing Split Pants, I'm going to make you a little surprise today. I'm going to make you some pirate booty for your tummy. So I need you to go sit because my assistants and I are ready. Goodbye. So Missy the Red is here to help make some pirate booty. So what we're going to be making is Walk the Plank Pirate Booty, which is a healthy snack and a sweet treat all in one. First, you're going to find things in your pantry. I don't want you going out to the store. Just find things you can throw in the bowl. Two, one healthy item must be in there. Raisins, dried fruits, or nuts. And a cold, hard pirate stare makes it all the better. Now, I need some help. I've got my bowl and I've got my stir, but I need my assistants to bring our pirate booty ingredients that they found in the pantry. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to dump the ingredients into the bowl. Like these dried up marshmallows would be good. What else we got?
Almonds.
All right, throw some almonds in there. Cheerios. Oh, that's good, that's good, that's good. I've got some M&Ms. Let's throw, I can't get a little bit. All right, some M&Ms. What do you think? One more? You need one? Need one? I need one. Some fruit snackies. Now, we've already put some nuts in there. Okay, I get this open. Okay, get it up. But I think these raisins would be delicious. You don't like raisins? I like raisins. Throw some in there. Now, we're going to give it a good stir. Oh, and just look at that delicious pirate booty. Come on, dive in.
Wait for me. I need some pirate booty too.
Enjoy.
All right, it's story time, and we are going to read Pout Pout Fish. Let me make this bigger. Pout Pout Fish by Deborah Deason, and pictures by Dan Hannah. I found this to be quirky book. Deep in the water where fish hang out lives a glum, gloomy swimmer with an ever-present pout. I'm a pout pout fish with a pout pout face, so I spread dreary wearies all over the place. Blob, blob, blob. I feel like a pout pout fish lately. Along comes a clam with a wide winning grin and a pearl of advice for her pal to take in. Hey, Mr. Fish, with your crosstown frown, don't you think it's time to turn it upside down? Says the fish to its friend. Nice thought, Ms. Clam. I hear what you're saying, but it's just the way I am. I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face, and I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub. Blub. Blub.
Along comes a jellyfish. He floats through the ocean, his tentacles all trailing in a gentle locomotion.
Hey, Mr. Fish, with your steep, scaly scowl, I wish you wouldn't greet us with a grimace and a growl,
says the fish to his friend.
Mr. Jelly, I'd agree. I'd like to be more friendly, but it isn't up to me, because I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face, so I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blab.
Along comes a squid, quite a slender, squiggly sight. She is squirmy, she is squelchy, she is slightly impolite.
Hey, Mr. Fish, you kaleidoscope a mope. How about a smile, a little joy, a little hope?
Says the fish to his friend.
Mrs. Squid, I would try, but I haven't a choice. Take a look and you'll see why. I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face, so I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blub.
Well, along comes an octopus with 8 great arms, covered on the underside with tiny sucker charms.
Mr. Fish, let me tell it to you straight. Your hunky-bunky sulking is an unattractive trait,
says the fish to his friend.
Mr. Ape, my chum, with a mouth like mine, I am destined to be glum. I'm a pow-pow fish with a pow-pow face, so I spread dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blub.
Now along comes a fish in a silent silver shimmer. The gang has never seen before this bright and brilliant swimmer. She approaches Mr. Fish, but instead of saying, hey, she plants a kiss upon his pout, and then she swims away. Mr. Fish is most astounded. Mr. Fish is just aghast. He is stone-faced like a statue, and he blinks and speaks at last.
My friends, said Mr. Fish, I should have known it all along. I thought that I was pouty, but it turns out I was wrong.
I'm a kiss-kiss fish with a kiss-kiss face for spreading cheery wearies all over the place. So I'll smooch and I'll smooch and smooch and smooch and smooch. Smooch! Mwah!
The end. Okay, that was a really fun book to read. Robert Weiland is a really famous mural artist, and he's famous for his underwater murals. His murals are as big as buildings, and they're always colorful and full of tremendous life. This mural is as big as a building, and it makes you feel as if you're underwater with all of the animals. There's an island called Grenada off the coast of South America, and in this island there's an underwater sculpture park, and you can only get to it by scuba diving underwater. How cool is that?
Hello, and welcome to Under the Sea Art Class, where we're going to draw one of my favorite fishy friends. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen, and then we will get drawing together. Fishy tail in my face! Let's see. Here we go. All right, so this is what we're gonna draw. This is my example. And let's go ahead and draw a fish. You can draw with markers, with crayons. I think I'm in the mood for using markers today for mine. So we're gonna start off, by the way, you know, reuse paper. All right, so we're going to start with a basic curve like this, like a little hill. And then we're going to put one on the bottom. Kind of looks like a big eye, doesn't it? And we're going to give them a fishy tail. So we're going to make a line like this. And we're going to make a line like that. And then we're going to come in and go boop. And I'm going to come in and go bloop and meet. And we want to give them a big old fishy eye. We'll put a little ring around that so it really stands out. We're going to give them a top fin. We're going to give them little flippers here. One. We'll tuck another one for the other side. And we're going to put a little line like that. We're going to do this and this. Same thing on this one. I just put some little designs. Now, with the designing part, you can do whatever designs you want to do. You don't have to do the same designs as me. I'm going to come around like this. So I just kind of went next to the eye and went like that, and then that. And I'm going to put a cool thing right here. And I'm going to do that again. I'm going to do one more. Yeah. I'm going to put a little design like this. Again, you can put your own designs on whatever you want. I'm going to do a little triangle there. A little triangle there. We need a little bit of light. Put a little design right here. Now we're going to go around the whole fish. Try to keep it kind of even all the way around if you can. If you don't make it perfectly even, don't worry about it, because obviously I didn't either. But we do the best we can. There we go. Then you want to put some more little tiny details in between here. So I'm going to just kind of make up some stuff. Toop, 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 toop. And I'm kind of looking what they have too. So they go like this. They make this big zigzag. And then they come in the other direction. And it makes these diamonds, which is a really cool kind of design. And it looks like they're doing triangle, 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 triangle. Yeah, I'm not loving that design. That's okay. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do that. Make sure, make it look like it goes together. What else can I do? I can put some little stripies in here. And literally, I'm just making this up. I gotta do it on the other side too, so it matches. So you would want to color this in, and notice that this fish over here is mostly red, which is a warm color, and then it is surrounded by blue and purple, which are cool colors. So we probably want to keep that in place of making the fish with warm colors mostly. They did put a little blue and purple in it, but like the red really stands out. For the background, so you see these little liney things that are happening here. They're just patterns, but they're kind of lines that radiate out. And then they have two of them, so it's kind of like a fat string coming. And you can pretty much make them straight. You can make them curvy. You can do that. You can do that. That was a crisscross. So what I did this, and then I went, and that was in the way. So I hopped over and kept going, and I did the same thing, hop over and kept going. And it makes an overlapping effect. So it makes it look like this piece is in front of that piece. That's always a good thing to do. I'm gonna make a curve here, one next to it. I think I'm gonna put a straight line here, and I think I wanna put a straight line here. And I'm gonna make that curve. And I think I'm gonna put one coming here. Again, we're gonna have that hop over thing. Hop over and do that, and then right next to it, hop over like that. I think I want a crisscrossy one here. Hop over and follow that. Hop over. All right, and then you fill the inside with all kinds of patterns. You could do something as simple as line patterns, straight lines. You could do something like, you could do a brick pattern. Brick patterns are pretty cool. I'm going to do one here. So you lay in your horizontal lines. These are like the rows of bricks. And then here's the trick to the brick pattern. So you pick the first layer and you put little lines like this, right? The key is in the second row, you want to have the line between the bricks. It actually is going to start in between where the first lines were. So there's that line. I'm going to go in the middle. In the middle of that one. In the middle and over here. So then when you skip to the third line, it's going to be the same place as the one. The third line is going to be the same place as one above. So you can, I like to do this. I go in the air. I kind of trace where it is and hop over and put that line in. I trace where it is, hop over, I put that line in. And then again, so we're just alternating. So now that lines up with that, that lines up with that, that lines up with that. And you just do that all the way down. You alternate lining up the spaces between the bricks. And if you don't get it perfect, quite honestly, no one's going to be able to tell. You could do something with a repeated pattern of geometric shapes. I could do triangles over here. I could maybe only have a part of a triangle. Maybe part of it's covered up by this stringy thing. Maybe there's just a piece shown here. Maybe there's just part of one there. Maybe part of one there. All right. So you get the idea. You're going to do whatever kind of lining patterns. And the key is filling it all in with interesting patterns, leaving these parts empty. But if you know what, if you draw over one of those by mistake, no one's going to notice. I like to do a design on one side and then repeat it on the other side. You don't have to have a completely new pattern for every section that you are filling in. Mm-hmm. And we'll put some stripes over here. Boom, 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 boom. I'm not making those bricks, just stripes. I could do like a zigzag, a really big zigzag. And then all these triangles I created, I'm going to add another triangle. And then you can even add a teeny, teeny, tiny one in there. All right, and then I think I want to do that up here too. Boom, 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 boom. So basically, you're doing your own designs in the background. You want to color in, dupe, dupe, and dupe. I colored my in. I used mostly warm colors on the inside of the fish. I use mostly cool colors. This is actually a green yellow, even though it looks yellow. So I hope that you make some beautiful fish and send me pictures. You can send them to mlnelson@chccs.k12.nc.us. It looks upside down on my screen, so it might be on yours. I'll read it again. mlnelson@chccs.k12.nc.us. Or you can join my Google Classroom. If you have not joined my Google Classroom, I sent everybody an email invite. But if you didn't see that email, send me an email to mlnelson@chccs.k12.nc.us. Send me an email, let me know, and I will send you another invite to the Google Classroom so that you can join it, and we post pictures there, and we comment on each other's pictures, and I even post all of my lessons are there, plus extra special lessons that I have posted for you. So enjoy your drawing. You can choose to complete one or all the lessons this week. You can do the crayon transfer drawing. You can make an accordion fish. You can draw a fish with Miss Nelson. And in Google Classroom, you can go to the 4-5 lessons and try any of those also, because both lessons are always different.
Somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things surround you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea. Darling, it's better. Cause you're in their bowl. With fish in the bowl is lucky. They ain't fall away.